a very interesting article we read around 3-4 months back, which covered that CIO in IT. And we were wondering about it, that CIO in IT, what exactly that terminology means. And they have mentioned it about that it is Chief Innovation Officer in IT. So it is, the CIO is a very common term, that CIO in IT was a new dimension that was given. And that thoughts rekindled again when I saw yesterday when Anupuyi was showing whether CIOs are obsolete. And even after 17 years of that article, that fraternity flourishing, and it is becoming more dominant actually. So, yeah, I think people are starting. So I'll start the joining, I'll start the presentation. So smart solution is intelligent integrated modular infrastructure for data centers, server rooms. Lot of things that we are hearing today that are about digital transformation, people are talking about Internet of Things. What exactly it means that in many industries, the business is not only supported by IT now, that it is driven by IT. And that is where I say that the CIO post is becoming more and more important even to consider how the infrastructures are built on these for these IT equipments that you are basically going to house on those infrastructures. And one thing is that this is an article, rather this is a presentation Gartner had covered, where they said that few years back, IT department was considered as a cost center, now which is turning it into a value center. And that is something very, very important from the CIO perspective, that when you have this as a value center, you have to dream big for the future and set up the infrastructures that go into building the businesses for future. Key trends, basically there is a lot of talk. We have a stall here where we have deployed a smart solution live unit for you to have a look at it. A lot of people who had visited also discussed their thought process, and we really welcome those kind of open discussions. Is one of the thing is about how the data center infrastructure is going to emerge. So we thought, why not we cover that point? Is there are multiple things like captive data centers, there is something about on-premise server rooms, there is a public cloud, there is a private cloud, and also is having some kind of the on-the-edge data center that will be on the premise. And there is also co-hosting and IT infrastructure at branch, regional level. Overall, but what is important here is the point here that has been mentioned is analysts are having different views about it, but what people finally feel is that it is going to be hybrid infrastructure. So it is not going to be either of the only one thing that is going to sustain, but it is going to be a mix and match depending on industry that you thrive in actually. And the kind of gathering what we have here, we see people from various industries, and that is where we felt this is a very important point that we will discuss on this forum. Again, one thing is there that when we are into building infrastructures that support IT, we need to closely follow the trends that are happening around. The virtualization is around from last 10 years, and we see the number of racks that are coming down drastically. The typical server rooms which used to host 15, 20 racks now are hosting only around 5, 6 racks kind of a stuff. But it is also doing one thing is that IT load is getting concentrated. It is earlier used to be 1.5 to 2 kilowatt per rack, which is now becoming almost 4 to 6 kilowatt per rack. There's other things that are happening around is high performance computing. There is a storage requirements that are going up. There's something that is going getting spoken about is about hyperconverged, which is also going to be like mixing of compute and storage requirements. And hyperconverged, what we understood from most of the people in that industry is hyperconverged is typically on-premise deployed IT infrastructure. So you need to have some slightly more sophisticated infrastructure built to house hyperconverged in your on-premise infrastructure. So all this basically is covering into solution requirements that cover better cooling and better power and monitoring. That is how this whole product solution that we have pitched in, smart solution, covers all these trends that are there in the industry. typically a server room is where you require, you have racks, you have some kind of a UPS power that is coming in, some kind of a cooling that is being provided. What we are talking about of a complete wheel where we have covered power, cooling, your rack infrastructure, power distribution, as well as your environmental monitoring and safety and security features also. One of the biggest thing that we hear, because this shift is happening from infrastructure people handling the data centers to CIOs getting into deciding what should be the data center infrastructure. Now when that happens, a lot of people feel that we are good at IT and why do we take a lot of headache on the infrastructure side of it, like UPS, like cooling or the access control and multiple things, that is around 7 to 8 vendors that get involved into building a data center or a server room space. So what we have tried doing is, with this solution, we are addressing most of the concerns that people have, is multiple vendors are not required. We are giving a complete solution in a box which contains cooling, monitoring, UPS, fire suppression, everything inbuilt into a single box. That kind of a infrastructure is available. You do not have to call multiple people. If you face any of the challenges, there is a single number that you need to call to. There is, because we are designing it ourselves for entire solution, there is no mismatch of different products having different capacities. So there is no oversizing. There is a lot of reduction in the OPEX cost. Basically, because from cooling entire room, we are moving to cooling only the IT infrastructure within the rack. And that is significant saving which we observe in the industry. There are other things about modular and scalable. It, you can keep adding. As the video has shown, there are, you can add the racks as and when you require. Apart from that, the last point, if you look at it, is plug and play. So you, once you have the infrastructure installed, you can just bring in your IT devices and start using them then and there. So this is the point I was talking about, as it is, infrastructure is vertically mounted, UPS, cooling, everything inside the box. You're saving almost 30% of space in a data center. You know, because of the OPEX cost are coming down, almost 30% of saving that is coming in the, your running cost of cooling because of the technologies that we use. So that, if you look at, Gartner says around 40% of the data center operational costs that are going into the cooling. That are recurring costs, that is biggest burden on your OPEX cost of a data center. And when you save there big time, as high as 30%, there is a good saving that comes on operation cost. There is also reduction in go live time. You will be surprised to know that we have done deployments of 10 rack data centers in flat 8 to 10 weeks time. And that is something miraculous for a lot of people who have built data centers themselves, have told that they have taken 4 to 6 months to build those kind of infrastructure. So we have brought down to 2.5 months to 3 months kind of time frame that serve. And apart from that, we are giving a centralized monitoring solution that helps your operation team to monitor entire data center from a single screen. What exactly it means is that smart solution is bringing an energy efficient infrastructure, it is faster deployed, reliability and uptime of your IT infrastructure is very important, and modular nature of deployment invest as you grow. That is where we keep talking about infrastructure being very important. I will cite a very simple example, like there is infrastructure. I will give a very simple analogy for what we use. That most of the time, the IT companies are going and talking about new trends in IT that are coming. So I just cite an example that I just take an analogy from the new high-speed cars that are coming, powerful engines, all that. So most of you traveled through this express highway. Imagine 15, 20 years back when this express highway was not there. Imagine using those high-speed cars on those normal roads. So what happens is you are not going to use that speed, that power of a car. There is also example of that Olympian, I think Deepa Karmakar, who was in that from Northeast. She was awarded a BMW, but she returned the BMW just because there is no infrastructure. She says that I don't have a road to take that big BMW to my house. Now that is exactly what we are talking. You may buy a hyperconverged paying 2.5 crore. You may buy the best of the Cisco devices, best of the IBM, Dell, HP devices. Now unless you have built a terrific infrastructure to house them, what we are trying to do is we really appreciate your abilities, capabilities and knowledge in the domain of IT. What we are trying to convey that when IT is changing, IT is shrinking from 10 racks to 4 racks, there is something that is changing along with it that needs a special attention on cooling, on monitoring. That is what we are trying to say. I'm trying to use this forum on behalf of Vertiv. Vertiv, because we are talking about green initiatives a lot from last few years. Let me cite one of our prime customer where we have done a 47 lakh annual saving just by doing UPS optimization. They used to use multiple high capacity UPSs which we worked with them and brought down the operational expense by 47 lakhs by optimizing the UPSs. So we do believe in green initiatives. And as we see that IT deployment is going to be driven more by CIO community even from the passive infrastructure side, this forum I'm trying to use to welcome few of you to come forward and we can work together because you have the best knowledge on what is changing on the IT side. And we can work together to find some kind of go-to-market from that perspective, from our product line, which meets the changing needs of IT. I think during the day, we can have a small sessions or discussions around it. Whoever are welcome, because it is going to go beyond our normal applications. It is going to save energy. It is going to help environment. So it is something what we are proposing for a CIO community to participate and help have green data centers going forward. Just a brief, it is a new concept that we are talking more about, but it is not that new. If you see, it is from 2013-14 that we are already there. 350 plus installations of these critical infrastructures. Believe me, even if it is one rack server room, people understand for their business, it is very critical and we understand that. So whoever have given us smart solution orders, we trust that they have given after a lot of deliberation. And getting 350 plus installations in last 3 years, and now it is the numbers are growing every month. Product lines that we offer, we have smart row solution, smart cabinet solution, smart aisle, as well as for the smart closet, for the even 15U kind of space where you have networking devices to be housed. So we do cover entire spectrum of products. These are the two things I tried covering is basically smart cabinet comes in 1 and 2 rack option. Smart row comes in from 2 racks to 8 rack or 2 rack to 10 rack option. And the high density IT rack can be handled by smart row. We have seen 4 to 6 kilowatt as a very standard kind of offering. But even we have catered to 11-12 kilowatt per rack kind of a load through smart row. Smart aisle, when you have more than 10 racks, we have this solution offering that we talk about smart aisle where you have 2 rows and there is a cold aisle containment. But again, this is complete solution we offer where UPS, cooling and all those kind of solutions are inbuilt into a single solution. I was motivated yesterday when I saw the participants where which all industries they do come from, and I thought I will put it across that we literally cover most of the industries that there we have corporate houses, media, services, pharmaceutical, defense, government, manufacturing, banking and finance, and the pharmaceutical I already covered, IT, ITS, BPO and education. All these verticals, we have various install base already available. We will share even the customer references during one-to-one discussion. So this is where I thought I will cover one point. It's a journey. It's a journey we need to do together. It's a journey that is a server rooms which we saw at few of the branch offices, from there to this kind of a smart infrastructure. This is a journey from this kind of a server room to this kind of a neat looking server room. I think everyone will appreciate that this is a journey to have for future, and we would like now that all the CIOs here, I will request all of you. First of all, I think it deserves a good round of applause for all the CIO who have won the various awards. I think let's clap for them. Thanks a lot. And I would like to have this last slide. Immersion network power is now Vertiv. So whoever customer CV, all the product lines remain same. The complete brand portfolio, entire operations, all remain same. So the people who have supported us, I just request for them to continue supporting us. We are all here at a stall. Our stall is just opposite to the registration counter. Do visit our stall during the day. Thank you. Thanks a lot.